In this video, I will explain the most important benefits of musculoskeletal ultrasound in sports medicine, as well as compare diagnostic accuracy of ultrasound versus MRI. I am a firm believer that musculoskeletal ultrasound leads to better patient satisfaction and outcomes. Ultrasound will completely revolutionize the practice of orthopedics and sports medicine, and I want to help you understand why. Let's get started. Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. Now, if this is the first time you're watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live an active and healthy lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. Now, I often give lectures to family medicine doctors in training, sports medicine specialists in training, and other practicing physicians. The following is a clip from a recent lecture that I gave examining why ultrasound leads to better patient satisfaction and better outcomes. Okay, so the next thing that I want to talk about is how ultrasound, specifically diagnostic and interventional ultrasound, is going to completely revolutionize how we practice orthopedics and how we practice sports medicine. And it all first starts with diagnostic ultrasound. So when someone first comes in and sees us, they get a thorough history, they get a thorough physical exam, and then on the same day, they get an in-depth diagnostic ultrasound evaluation. And what this does is it helps expedite diagnosis. So if someone needs to go to physical therapy, I can write on the physical therapy referral exactly what they have. So-and-so has a partial tear in their supraspinatus tendon, as well as a thick subacromial subdeltoid bursa. And then the physical therapist is going to know exactly what to do in terms of a rehab program. And then we'll also talk about how cost-effective ultrasound evaluations are when compared to MRI. All of this results in better patient satisfaction and better outcomes. So when we start talking about outcome data, right? What is the diagnostic accuracy of an ultrasound versus the diagnostic accuracy of an MRI? And of course, this has got to be done by a trained musculoskeletal sonographer, whether that's an MSK radiologist, whether that's an ultrasound-trained sports medicine physician. So this study was done out of the radiology department at UCLA, imaging of the shoulder, a comparison of MRI and ultrasound. And what they did was they compared the diagnostic accuracy of MSK ultrasound as well as MRI, and they compared that to surgical findings. And if you look at partial thickness tears of the rotator cuff, MSK ultrasound had 94%, whereas MRI had 92%. Full thickness tears, 96% for ultrasound, 95% for MRI. So pretty much exactly the same diagnostic accuracy for partial and full thickness tears of the rotator cuff. But now let's talk about cost. So what you see here is just a ballpark cost in our area. And of course, the true value is going to vary from patient to patient based off their insurance situation. But you look at how much an ultrasound evaluation, a diagnostic musculoskeletal ultrasound evaluation, is going to cost, and it's orders of magnitude cheaper. So all of this results in, if you can get the same diagnostic accuracy but significantly less cost, of course, people are going to be happier, right? They don't have to wait a week or two to get MRI approval, then go get the radiology study done, then follow up with their provider, and then get a new referral to a physical therapist telling them exactly what they have. Everything is done on day one at the visit, at the initial time of consultation. This results in better patient satisfaction. Now, what about outcomes? And when we talk about outcomes data, we're really talking about ultrasound-guided injections. So this study was published in the Orthopedic Journal of Sports Medicine, existing evidence on ultrasound-guided injections in sports medicine. And this is the big summary table from this study that you can see compared. They're comparing ultrasound-guided accuracy of injections, ultrasound-guided injections versus landmark-based injections. Across the board, for the most common musculoskeletal injections that we do, there is no comparison. Ultrasound-guided injections are far, far better. And you may stop and think, like, well, yeah, that makes sense. You're using imaging guidance, but does this really matter? Does this really affect outcomes? And so what I really want to do is I want to talk about the knee joint and use a very excellent example of how, yes, it absolutely matters. So this is the practice guideline from the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons on whether to use hyaluronic acid or viscose supplementation for the treatment of knee osteoarthritis. So you can read their practice guideline here. Hyaluronic acid injections is not recommended for routine use in the treatment of symptomatic osteoarthritis of the knee. Okay, and that's what our surgical colleagues, what their practice guidelines say. Now look at the non-surgical guidelines. So the AMSS, American Medical Society for Sports Medicine, we recommend viscosupplementation injections for osteoarthritis in those patients above the age of 60 based on high quality evidence. And we suggest viscosupplementation injections for knee arthritis for those under the age of 60 based on moderate quality evidence. What about our rheumatology colleagues? So the American College of Rheumatology, they recommend the use of intra-articular hyaluronic acid injections for the treatment of arthritis of the knee in adults. And what about our European colleagues? There is evidence to support the efficacy of hyaluronic acid in the management of knee arthritis, both for pain reduction and functional improvement. So what's the difference here, right? Should we be doing hyaluronic acid injections, yes or no? You have non-surgical societies saying yes, you have a surgical society saying no. And what they're really asking, what the real problem here is, what is the difference between an ultrasound-guided injection versus a landmark-based injection? And what are the outcomes? Is there true outcome data between ultrasound-guided injections versus landmark injections? And the answer is yes. So this study was published in the Journal of Ultrasound Medicine, Rethinking Viscosupplementation. This was done at the Mayo Clinic. And what they found was patients receiving ultrasound-guided knee hyaluronic acid injections were significantly less likely to undergo subsequent knee arthroplasty, which is a knee replacement surgery, than patients receiving landmark-guided hyaluronic acid injections. And you go back to this initial graph, right? Ultrasound-guided accuracy, 96 to 100%, landmark-based, 60 to 90%. If you're missing anywhere between 20 to 40% of the time with your hyaluronic acid injections, of course you're not going to get good results. And of course that's going to affect outcomes. So ultrasound guided injections definitely results in better patient satisfaction and better outcomes. And if you're interested in learning more about other types of injections that we use to treat knee arthritis, check out this video next. Thanks for watching.